Wednesday morning. Now, they say that bad things happen in threes. And yesterday, what happened to me, the first out of the three was the TV in the gym that we display the percentages and stuff for the spreadsheet just stopped working. I was literally had the spreadsheet up with percentages and stuff on it and everything going perfect. And the next thing, bang, TV just 38 lines down it. And it looks like someone almost hit it with something, like there was impact on it, but there was none of that. So the TV just stopped working, right? So that's number one. The second thing that happened then was the Echo Bike monitor just started to start beeping. It was like beep, beep, beep. And you went to press start on it and nothing was happening. So we've had to take the monitor off, email Rogue, and waiting on a replacement one to come back from them. So that was the second one. And then the third thing that happened then actually happened this morning. So while I was replacing this TV, I got this TV from the house. I had a spare one, took it in, kind of rushing about. And while I was in here putting this up then, my van ran straight into a wall there. Now, luckily enough, there's no damage on it. The handbrake, I forgot to pull it up, and it must have just like crawled up and just hit the wall and then stopped. No damage done. But had that wall not been there, on the other side of that, there's like a river, and it would have just went whew, all the way down. So hopefully that's my three bad things done and dusted now for the weekend for a long time. And we got over them all and we're sorted, so we're starting back into training now after getting all them hiccups addressed. For the first piece of day, we're going to be doing some push jerks. Now, I have already got my opening weight on the barbell up there. I warmed up to it. I haven't done the first set yet, but I will now in a second. And that first set is going to be a set of 12 at 48% or 53 kilos. Then we're going to set a 10 at 58%, 64 will make that 65. Then we have a set of 8 at 67%, 75 kilo, we'll round that up to. And then we're going back again then, 12, 10, 8, 52%, 61 and 70%. And they will be 58 kilo, 68 kilo and 78 kilos. So that is the first piece of the day and we'll get started at it. First sets of 12, 10, 8 done. We went 53, 65, 75, and they were all feeling nice. We are going to increase it again now. We're heading back 12, 10, 8 again. That 53 is going to increase by 5 kilo to 58. The 10s are going to go up to 68, and the 8s are going up to 78. Push jerks done, they were feeling grand, not too heavy at all, but a volume in 12, 10s and 8s, but overall not too bad. Next thing we're getting into now is some squat cleans. Every 2 minutes for 5 sets, we're going to be doing one single squat clean. The goal here is to be anywhere between 90 to 100% of your one rep max. If you've been following along, we've been doing sets of 5s, 3s, 2s last week, now we're into singles this week. And the idea of this here is 90 to 100%, but if you can't get in between that or you're not sure what to go, as long as you try and go heavier than what you did your 5x2s at last week. Now for me last week I did the 5x2s at 110 kilos, so I am just looking to go north of that. Now by how much, I'm not sure. My legs are feeling heavy and a wee bit sore, especially after all the front squatting I've been doing. As I said before, we're doing a 6 week cycle on the front squat. I'm starting week 5 now. I've done day 1 yesterday, so I've got 2 more days to do this week and day 5, and then next week then will be the final week of it. So it's coming near the end. The volume has gone up a bit, the weights have gone up, so I'm a wee bit tender, but again, not going to use that as an excuse. I want to get stuck into these cleans and we're going to try and get above 110. So that's the plan now. We'll get to our working weight and then we'll start these 5x1s. Right, so this is how it's went so far. When I was warming up, I did 60, 80, 100, and now 110, and I hit 110 without a belt. Now, as I say, this piece is to be between 90 to 100% of your one rep max. My one rep max is 123 kilos, and I've hit that once in my life. So what I might do now is, just for the crack, I'm gonna put on 123 kilos from 110. I'm gonna see, can I hit it? And if I hit it, depending on how I feel then, I'm either gonna keep going at that for the rest of the singles, or I'll have to come back down. But I just think that I'm feeling fairly good now, confident in that warming up there. I know this is a big jump, it's 13 kilos, but I'm gonna just try it. I got a whole lot of new subscribers there the other day, so again, that's what I'm talking about, keeping me accountable. If your eyes is watching me, then I'm gonna try and perform a bit better then as well. So It's kind of like creating a hype, even though I'm in here just me and the dog, but I'm creating a hype to try and get myself fired up. So I'm going to put a belt on, I'm going to put another 13 kilo on that, and I'm going to try and hit my one rep max for five singles. Well, I'll try and hit it for one first just to see. Not a chance, I'm gonna have to come back down. Maybe I'll try 115 or so. Right, so 115 was a more sensible decision. I thought, you know, I'll get it, I'll get it, I'll get it, but nah. So we're gonna stick to 115 now for five singles. And maybe after we do the five singles at that, we might try get 120, and then 123, try and hit the PB. But for now, anyways, 123 seems a long way away. Three out of the five reps done, I have two more to go. I'm trying not to sit too long between them. I think if I keep moving, I feel better at it. So, two more to go, and we're gonna get into them next time. Hey! So four done now, so far so good. One more single at 115 kilos, as I say. It was a bit adventurous to go for the 123. 115 is hard, but it's manageable, and it's still a 5 kilo jump up from last week's double, so it's exactly as we wanted it to be. Progressive overload, I was just being greedy. Right, one more to go. Hey! Five singles heavier than last week, done and dusted. So we're playing with house money here now. I'm gonna just go 120 now. I'm gonna just try it. I'm feeling fairly good. I've got an Ian Mumford and Sons songs on there, and I'm gonna just try and get this 120 now. Right. Nothing to lose and all to gain. Yes! Woo! Yes! Right, we hit the 120. I'm gonna just go straight to 125. Fuck the 123. Try the PB. Let's go, come on! Yes, we did. That's the stuff there, isn't it, Pat? I was giving out to you just to get out of the way, but I didn't mean it. I didn't mean it. I was just in the zone. Oh, I do love you. Pat, we PB'd it, sir. We PB'd it, Pat. A 2 kilo jump to. I am delighted. Brilliant. Brilliant, 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 brilliant. Thanks a million too, hey. That's again down to all the subscribers that are following and watching. If you weren't watching, I would probably not have pushed that on there. It's called to the eyes. And that's why I'm telling you, I want the subscriber for accountability. That's all I want, hey. And thanks so much. Brilliant, Pat. A 2 kilo jump. Happy days. Oh, I'd love to get a 130 on down the line. Obviously not today, but whew, a 130 would be beaut. Right, that's class. Oh, pumped to that. Right, hey, I don't even mind you putting the ball down there the day in an awkward spot because I'm in that good humour now, I'll get it. I came into the day's session tired and feeling kind of groggy and just couple of things went wrong, as I say, nearly put the van in the river, TV broke, Rogue Egobike broke. But you just have to kind of chip on through, hey, and then ended up then like hitting the 115 for the 5, which was a 5 kilo jump. Happy with that. Just tried the 1, 2, 3, no chance at all. Hit the 5 singles, nice and warm. 120, hit, feeling good. And then I knew that if I had hit 1, 2, 3, that's grand, I would have matched my PB, but I don't know, like, if this is right or wrong, maybe you should hit 1, 2, 3 first and then go to 1, 2, 5. Maybe you should take small jumps. But I just slapped on the 1, 2, 5 and up she went. I'm just delighted. I really, really delighted. Shows you that that front squat cycle I'm doing is paying off too on the cleans, because you kind of, your legs are strong, aren't they? Like, so as long as you just commit to the lift, get in underneath it, you'll stand it up. Now, it was a struggle to stand up, definitely was. It was tight, but it's going to be when it's up near your backs. But 3 kilo PB, or 2 kilo PB, so up from 123 kilo to 125. Brilliant. Like, I mean, like, that was numbers I wouldn't even have dreamt about whenever I started. Not even dreamt about. 60, 70, 80 would have been serious. So, like, to be at 125, just consistency again, talking about just do the pull-ups, just show up, hey, all the time. Days you think, it's not working, but that does, and it just clicks in. Like, you just have to trust the process, because it does, definitely does work. And, like, I'm just a normal person, like, nothing special about me, far from special, and I can make progress. So, you can't do it. Right, I don't even care about this workout now. It's a 10-minute AMRAP, right? It's 12 deadlifts, 9 hang power cleans, 6 push jerks. Then you're going to do 6 toes to bar. You're going to go back around that again, and then the next round, you're going to do 9 toe to bar, 12 toe to bar, 15 all the way up. So the only thing that's changing is you're adding 3 toes to bar each time. It's basically, it's DT with some toes to bar at the end of it. If you haven't done DT whenever you're doing this, see the 12 deadlifts. Do 11 deadlifts, then drop, then pick it back up for your 12th deadlift, and that's you in position then to go to your hang power cleans, and then unbroken on the hang power cleans into the push jerks. So that's why I'm going to do that from day dot. The barbell on this is 60 kilo. Now DT is usually 70. This workout is going to be done at 60, but I'm just going to chip through it. I really don't even care if the place crumbled around me now. I'm just happy and content with that PB for the day. Brilliant. Right, we'll get into this wee 10-minute AMRAP. Right, that's the workout done, folks. Said going into it, I'm not quite bothered about that for score of the day. I was just so happy to put all my energy into that clean and hit that PB. And another reason I have this snatching week 6 day 1 to do, either tonight or tomorrow. But I wasn't feeling wild energetic coming into the session, so I want to kind of keep a bit of energy for the snatching. As I say, tonight's my main focus, trying to snatch that 100 kilos is the goal. So just move through that one steady, nothing. Definitely no wild serious effort on it. Finished up with, I did the round of 15 toes to bar, and then I got 12 deadlifts and 3 hang power cleans, so 4 and 15, so happy enough with it in fairness, but just more so happy with that clean. And I'll be more so happy to go home now and get rested and get in and get the snatching done tonight, which would mean then I could take a full rest day tomorrow. What's been happening the last while is the snatching's taking over the rest days. Thursday and Sundays have kind of been the days for that. And then 3 other days a week, then we're squatting, so there's a lot going on. There's not much recovery, so I just need to kind of put the intensity, adjust the intensity to allow for the lack of recovery. And the reason too, like, I'm kind of pushing it a bit is because Christmas is coming. There's going to be heaps of days to sit and recover over Christmas. So that's the reason why. But great session. Again, thanks to everybody who's hit the subscribe button this last couple of days, commenting. Thank you very, very much for that. You can see there what it means to me. Keep them eyes on me and push me to do the clean. Maybe if I was in here on my own, like, that wouldn't happen. So thank you very much for that. Right, we'll see you on tomorrow maybe, or else tonight. Whatever, you'll see me someday soon for the snatching video. It'll either be out tomorrow or it'll be out tonight, one of the two. See you then. Good luck.